KUKA.VisionTech is an optional software we sell together with camera, which is focused on 2D applications. That could be positioning, recognition of objects, quality control, or even optical character reading, OCR, R reading, and code reading to some extent. We do have other types of vision applications as well. For example, 3D vision systems, which we actually plan not to dive so deep into today, but we will set up a separate webinar in a few weeks on this topic. And for those of you who have been with me before, you know that I like to make it easy for myself. So today I'm actually letting my colleague Elin do most of the presentation. So Elin, over to you. Let me just quit my screen sharing here.
Thank you very much, Mikael. I will try to get my screen share on. Just give me a moment. Can you see my screen here? I hope so. Yes, as Mikael said, I will present to you the function and also the application possibilities for the software KUKA.VisionTech. And KUKA.VisionTech is used to determine and correct the position of a robot relative to the position of a component with the aid of one or more cameras. Therefore, the typical applications of this software is detecting of position of components, deracking, and also depalletizing. Here on the screen, you can see the product portfolio with the vision components included to this software package. First of all, it's the software, VisionTech software, obviously. And there are also a selection of 2D cameras with the following camera lenses. To be able to use several cameras on the network and also have a power over Ethernet interface, there are a KUKA switch available. And there is also an option of a KUKA industrial PC that could be selected if you need a higher image calculation. It also comes with a calibration plate and obviously also the cabling for the cameras and the switch and everything. Here on the screen you can see you can see the setup of the workflow during the integration of VisionTech application. On the left-hand side, you see the production setup where the camera is connected to the controller and where it's on the controller that the VisionTech software and also the Ethernet CarL software is installed for communication with the camera. And on your own office desktop, you have the work visual and also a license for the VisionTech software. And it's on your own workstation. You can do the configuration of the work block and toolbox and etc. On the workstation, you can do the configuration of the tags, the generation of toolblocks, and you can also get a live view of the camera image and transfer image data sets. Yes. So, what is the benefits of using VisionTech in your production? I will dive a little bit deeper into this benefits? The benefits of the solution comes in the cost effectiveness, and it requires only the camera and no additional image processing hardware if you don't select the KUKA industrial PC. So the image processing is handled by KUKA, and it works also with all KUKA robots, so it's not a robot dependent software. The high reliability and high performance flexibility is an effect of the Cognex library on the Cognex camera that is included in the software, and which delivers powerful and robust algorithms, which makes it possible to recognize a large range of parts. And the possible applications for this is object detection, feature presence check, distance measurement, and it also includes a collision check for gripper, so you don't collide during pickup of parts, and also in some extent code reading. This also leads to less effort for integration because of the programming possibilities in WorkWizard. It's a wizard-based programming where you can define the tasks by setting the regions of interest and objects, defining the objects right on your screen. Even though the most of the configuration and setup is done on your workstation, there is also some smaller shop floor adjustments that could be done over the smart pad. And this is could be done during commissioning or during operation. In this wizard, it's also possible to perform the calibration on the smart pad. So if you have a stationary camera, you perform the calibration with the calibration plate on the robot and vice versa. So to do this calibration, you need no, it's quite self-guiding, and you need no expert knowledge in vision to do this. It also comes with a web server for image viewing during production. So you can control the image that is being taken during your production. And the camera is possible to mount in two different ways. First of all, you have a stationary option where you put the camera apart from the robot, like you see on the left-hand side on the image. You can put it over the workpiece, and the benefit of that is that you get a shorter time for your cycle time, because since the image processing can take a little bit of time, the robot doesn't have to wait for it to happen. Which is the case if you put it on the robot flange. This is suitable for objects on the same height, for example, a workstation or a conveyor, a still standing conveyor. We will come to it later, how you can solve it with a moving conveyor. And on the right-hand side, you can see the option if the camera is mounted on the robot. And if you do this, you have to use an additional sensor for detecting the heights of the work objects. And you should not use this for any critical time critical applications. But it could be beneficial because you don't have to have an extra strand with the camera in your cell and so on. As I said before, there are possibilities to use if you want to use vision on a moving conveyor, and that is the option package KUKA Pick Control, which is suitable for fast pick and place applications where you have both a vision and a conveyor. So here we recommend that you use this package instead. And if it's of any interest, we can arrange a webinar in a few weeks. So please comment if you think that would be interesting. And for, as Mikael mentioned earlier, there's also another option if you're interested in 3D vision applications, for example, bin picking applications. And that software is called KUKA Perception Tech. So that could also, we can also arrange some type of webinar if you want to learn more about this option. So if you're looking into using this softwares, and you obviously maybe need some training, and during normal circumstances, there are 4 times a year special training offered for VisionTech in Augsburg, KUKA headquarters. But now we are in a little bit different situation here. So if you are interested in learning more, please contact us and we can see if we can arrange some workshop or in or remote in our KUKA college here in Gothenburg. So please contact us if it's of any interest. Yes, this was all from my side today. So thank you very much, and over to Mikael.
Thank you very much.
Now we'll just quit.
Yeah. So it was a pretty short webinar today. As being having some experience working with vision applications in general before, I have some questions to Elin here. But in general, the programming of the vision systems are quite easy. The challenge is usually the setup around the vision camera, isn't it correct to say? And I would even say that more important than providing the best possible lighting circumstances around the camera, it's more important to provide stable lighting circumstances. Wouldn't that be true?
Yes, exactly. The setup of the software and everything around the camera and the communication is quite straightforward. And as Mikael says, it's usually something in the surrounding that is the most challenging part of this type of applications. And the programming will be different for each type of project. Thank you.
Now we got a question from Knut here, where he asks, I assume it's a Cognex camera, which is correct. Can all Cognex cameras be used? Well, I got half an answer on that at least, and that is no, because half of the Cognex cameras are smart cameras in themselves. And in this application where we use VisionTech, it's actually the robot controller which runs the software doing the picture analysis. So we only need a stupid camera, if you like, in lack of other words, really, here. But I don't think it's the complete range of Cognex cameras which are available here, as far as I know. I have to double check a little bit here, Knut. can get back to you. While you figure out a bit more questions, I would like to leave you with a small video, which is a vision of application, obviously, but it is a little bit different with vision application. Or they have been, the integrator has been quite creative from my point of view.
KUKA.
KUKA.